Hi guys, my name is Anna and today I'm going to show you guys how to do this very beautiful and easy bronzy smoky eye look. So if you want to learn how to do this look, then just please keep on watching. Okay guys, so as you can tell, I do not have your typical perfect makeup YouTube girl perfect beautiful skin. I'm going to go ahead and show you how I cover all of this up. A bunch of acne and a bunch of scars. First we're gonna start off with priming. For priming, I like to use three different things. I like to use the Nivea Men Aftershave. I like to mix the Nivea Men Aftershave with this e.l.f. moisturizer. So I'm gonna go ahead and prime my eyelids with this Tarte Shape Tape Concealer. I only just do like a few dots on my eyelids because this stuff, a little goes a long way with this stuff. And I just like to use my fingers for this, like it's not that big of a deal. So now I'm going to set my eyelids with some Airspun, Coty Airspun. We're going to use the Jaclyn Hill palette today. So we're going to start off with this color right here. It's called Creamsicle. And I'm gonna take it on a Wet n Wild blending brush. I seriously love these brushes. They are such good brushes and they're only like 99 cents. Seriously, such great brushes. Like, I really love them. I have so many of them. They're really great. So I'm just gonna take this color back and forth and I'm just gonna keep adding on to the color until I get it to the amount of darkness that I want it to be. And just blending it back and forth above the crease. So we're going to go back into the Jaclyn Hill palette and I'm going to take this shade right here. I believe it's called Pookie. We're going to take this color right there and we're going to put it all over the crease. And for this, I'm going to use the Morphe M441 brush. Take this color. We're going to take this color into the crease and we're going to do little circular motions with the brush. So now that I've gotten to the desired shade that I want with that pukey color, I'm gonna go back in with the brush that I first used with the creamsicle color in it, and I'm just gonna try to blend everything together. I'm gonna go in with this shade right here from the palette. It's called Mocha, and we're gonna put that at the outer corner. We're gonna put it in our outer corner. To give it a little bit of a smoky look. And for this shade, I'm gonna take a Morphe M433 brush. For darker colors, you wanna start off with a little bit and then work your way up to help prevent mistakes and stuff. So we're just gonna put it at our outer corner right here and just build up the color. And just do little circular motions, little windshield wiper motions. And then we're going to start to bring it into the crease. We're going to go in with this shade right here. It's called Queen. And we're gonna just lay this color out at the very half inner corner to like the center of her lid. You know what I mean? We're gonna put that color there. So I'm gonna take this Wet n Wild brush, this flat brush that was like $2, I think. And we're gonna put this color on this brush. And we're gonna take some setting spray. I'm gonna use the Mario Badescu setting spray. Spray it a little bit. You're putting down the shimmer shade on your lid that you first pat and then drag. Pat, drag, pat, drag, pat, drag. That you're patting and then you're dragging the shade. Cause that'll lay down the most product on your eyelid. Okay, so I'm back and I've done my other eye. I usually, after I finish doing my eyes, I don't like to put on mascara or my eyelashes just because like I might get like concealer or like powder or something on them and I don't want them to look like white or ashy or anything. So I just wait until I'm done with my face to put on my lashes and like do my under eyes and all that stuff. So for my foundation, since I do have very obviously pimply acne scars and I have a very oily face, I do like to use a mattifying foundation. I do not do dewy foundations, hydrating foundations. I don't do any of that stuff. I like to use full coverage mattifying foundations all the time, no matter what. And today I'm going to be using this Wet n Wild foundation. I got it from Walmart, $5, such a great foundation. I truly love this foundation. It's very great. I highly recommend it if you have like acne scars, pimples, or if you just want something mattifying that is very full coverage. I highly recommend this foundation. And I'm gonna put on my foundation using this Real Techniques brush. I don't remember what it's called, but I really love this brush. It's very dense, so it really packs on the foundation. So yeah, let's go ahead and put some foundation on. A little bit of this foundation does go a long way. I find that if you use a beauty blender with this foundation, it does make it less like full coverage, but I like the full coverage, so I don't use beauty blenders for foundation. And when I'm putting on my foundation, I don't like to move around. I like to just like pat it in and just drag it down a little bit. But I don't like to move my foundation around because it gives me less coverage and I want all the coverage I can get. Okay, so now we're gonna go in with concealer for under our eyes. So I usually like to mix two concealers. I really, really love this Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. It's such a great concealer. I really, really love it. And I mix in a little bit of the Tarte Shape Tape Concealer as well. So I take my concealer and I put it under the eyes. And then I just drag out whatever is left. I just drag it out like that. Just a little tiny triangle. Same thing on the other side. Okay, and then I'm gonna go in with my Tarte Shape Tape. And I only put some on the inner corner, and I try not to do a lot of this foundation because this stuff is just hardcore. The little goes a long way with this stuff. So now I'm gonna take my beauty sponge, and this is actually the Morphe sponge. I just recently purchased it and I'm just testing it out to see how I like it. This is like my second or third time trying it, like using it. So we're just testing the waters. Okay, so now that I feel like everything is pretty well blended out, I'm gonna go in with my Coty Airspun Translucent Powder. And I'm just gonna take some on my sponge. Okay, so now that I've finished setting under my eyes and it looks very nice, I like to take a little bit more. I like to take this much on my sponge and then just put it on my smile lines because my smile lines are whack. I hate my smile lines. I always get smile lines. It's like ridiculous. And then whatever's left, I just place it on my chin. And then I do take a little bit and then I just put it on my forehead. And then just down the center of my nose as well. And also, I find that if I put some setting powder on my acne, like, it makes the makeup there like last longer. I'm gonna go ahead and take this ABH brush. I don't remember what it is. I think it's number 12. This ABH brush, I believe it's number 12. I'm not sure because like it wiped off. I've had this brush forever. And I'm also gonna take the ABH pomade and the shade Ebony. Yeah, pomade lip brow. And what I like to do when I'm doing my eyebrows is I like to brush them up first. And then I like to make a straight line right beneath my eyebrow. See, just a straight line. And then once I get to the front of my brow, I do the same thing, the straight line, but very lightly. Very lightly. And then after that, I just go in with whatever's on the brush and I just start filling in my brows. Well, so now that I've filled in my eyebrow with the dip brow, I'm gonna go in with this ABH brow pencil. I've also had it for a very long time, and this pencil is in the shade dark brown, and I'm literally just gonna go in and just fill in whatever like sparse areas I have. So now we're gonna go ahead and clean up the eyebrows. So what I like to use to clean up the eyebrows is this concealer brush from Wet n Wild. I like to use the Maybelline concealer that I've been using to like bake to highlight and stuff. I like to use these two to clean up the bottom of my brow. Okay, so what I like to do is I like to take a little bit of the Maybelline concealer and I just put some on the back at the back of my hand, and then just take some on my brush and I underline the bottom of my brow. And I just go in very lightly because it could get very messy real quick. And since I already did my eyes and stuff, I try my best to not mess up on this. Hey guys, so I finished up my brows and my camera died and I didn't notice, so I ended up doing my bottom, my lash line right here. I used this NYX Jumbo Pencil, in Fries, and I used that as my liner. And then I just went in with the same three colors that we use, so Creamsicle, Mocha, and Pukey. I went in with those colors and just blended them out on my lash line, and that's all I did. And then I also ended up setting my face with some powder. I used the Fit Me powder, and that's all I've done so far. I'm sorry my camera died and I didn't notice. To bronze my skin, I'm gonna use this Wet n Wild bronzer, the Color Icon bronzer. And I'm gonna use this Revlon brush that I've had for the longest time. I don't know what it's called. Maybe it's like a powder brush, I'm not sure. But I use it to bronze my face. So we're gonna get some of that bronzer on this brush. With this bronzer, you really have to like build it up, so I do use a lot of this bronzer, and it does have like a little bit of a shimmer in it. It's not anything crazy, but Yeah, it is there, and some people like it, some people don't. To me, like, it doesn't really bother me, like, I don't really notice it. So now we're gonna go on with the second bronzer. I know this is a lot of bronzing, but I really do want to look very, like, tan and sun-kissed for this look. So now I'm gonna go in with my Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer with this Wet n Wild contour brush. I'm not really gonna contour. I'm just gonna add a little more darkness and definition. Take the color Summer and Moonstone on a Morphe M5. I'm gonna use this MAC blush that I'm like almost out of, and it's in the shade Warm Soul. I need to get some more of this blush because this blush is really good. This is a really good blush. And then just put it on the apples of my cheek. Next we're gonna apply lashes, and the lashes that I'm gonna use are from Salon Perfect. They're Go Glam. I bought these at Walmart and I just bought them just to like try them out, and I ended up liking them. And I customized my own pair. I just added two of the same lashes, the Go Glam lashes. I just stacked them on top of each other. I'm gonna go ahead and apply the eyelash. When I'm applying lashes and I really want them to stand out, I grab the eyelash. I usually like to grab my eyelashes with tweezers, and when I'm bringing the eyelash in, I like to come in from the top. So just like that, coming in from the top. And placing them as close as possible to the lash line. And holding it there, and I'm gonna hold the eyelash there for a sec, just so that it really sticks on. And I'm just gonna go ahead and place the edges down. So thank you guys so much for sticking through to the end of this video. It means a lot. If you guys like this video, then make sure to give it a thumbs up, and on your way out, don't forget to subscribe. So I'll see you guys next time. Bye!